Basically, the tumor bank is, I would say it's a bridge. It serves as a bridge because on the one hand you have laboratory research on cancer that uses cells or animals, or you know, and that generates a lot of new molecular information. And then on the other hand you have information that are the observations of the doctors in the clinics about the patient, the diagnostic, the way they respond to treatment and so on. Over the last 2-3 years, we have a big number of examples of new discoveries about cancer due to biobanks. And it is due to the capacity of analyze markers over the whole genome of a subject. Since the work on the human genome that has looked at the variation within the genome of human people, we know that even if everybody has the same genes, we have about 1 million small differences from one person to another. So the use of biospecimens allow you to put the two together. You can test the markers that you can isolate in laboratory work and then see if it is useful to help the doctors to better understand, describe the cancer, make the prognosis of who is going to respond well to treatment, and more or less to have to choose an adequate treatment, because each cancer is different, every patient is different. So by knowing the exact markers and mechanisms that are at work in the cancer of one patient, you can choose among the drugs which one has a better chance to work.